Hello, my name is Akshay Tangsale, and you're watching the recorded lecture for Introduction to Process Simulations. In today's lecture, we are going to talk about how to model iterative solution for reactive and non-reactive processes with a recycle and without a recycle. By the end of this chapter, you should be able to model a process using mass balances only in Excel and in Aspen Plus. Model a process containing yield reactor, separator, and a recycle stream, and program nonlinear equations using correct options for calculations, convergence, and their effect on convergence to a solution. Details of methods for mass balances for non-reactive and reactive systems are covered in CHE2162, which is material energy balances. But in this unit, we are going to cover methods for solving them in Excel and in Aspen Plus with and without a recycle. A process without a recycle can be solved one block at a time and is called as a sequential mass balance. And processes with recycle stream need an iterative balance because we don't know the composition of a mixed stream until we have solved all of the blocks. But then it needs to be solved in an iterative system. So we'll have to assume a value for a recycle stream and then solve all the blocks and try and match the value of the recycle stream for the true value after all the calculation with the assumed value at the start of the calculation. We'll have a look in detail when we do our work problem. This is the way Aspen Plus also solves a problem with the recycle stream. It will have a tear stream which it gives an assumed value and then solves all the blocks and then try and match the true value of the tear stream with the assumed value at the start. So therefore, in Aspen Plus, if the process has got a very complex recycle system, then the sequential modular approach, which also uses the iterative approach, can be very slow and can take a long time to converge. So initially, we can do sequential modular approach, but then eventually, you may have to learn how to do equation-oriented modeling, which we'll cover later in the unit. Just quickly recapping the formulas that we will be using. For all non-reactive systems like mixers, splitters, and separators, the component mass balances are reduced to input equals to output because there is no generation and there is no consumption of the components. So moles out of a mixer for every component I will be equal to sum of all the streams for that component I. Likewise for a splitter, moles in for a component I will be equal to sum of all the streams for component I going out of that splitter. For a separator, moles out in the overhead product, which is N2, is equal to moles in of a component I multiplied by the split fraction. We call this split fraction recovery in material energy balances, and recovery can sometimes be calculated if, say, one of the recovery information is given. For example, if it's a benzene and toluene distillation, for example, and recovery of benzene in the overhead product is given, we can calculate the recovery of other in the streams in the bottoms product using the formulas here. The recovery may also be calculated if composition is given instead. So for example, if looking at the benzene and toluene example again, if the problem says that the purity of benzene is 99.9% in the overhead product, and we know the mole flow rates of benzene and toluene coming in, we should be able to calculate the recovery information from mass balances and then work out the composition and flow rate for the bottom product. Here we look at an example where propane, isobutane, normal butane, isopentane, and normal pentane are separated in a distillation train. A distillation train is a number of distillation columns in sequence where one of the products is separated or purified in each distillation column. In this case, propane, being the lightest hydrocarbon, comes out from the first distillation column as an overhead product, followed by isobutane, followed by normal butane, isopentane, and then in the bottoms product of the last distillation column, we get normal pentane. Here we have been given recovery information for each component in the overhead streams of the distillation train. The key here is this is overhead stream. So for all the bottoms product, the split ratio will be 1 minus of these numbers. So we convert the process flow diagram that was given to us into a block flow diagram to make it simpler for us to solve this problem. And we give a stream number to each stream and a separator number to each separator. And then we set up an Excel flow sheet where I've labeled the title of the problem, and all the flow rates that were given to us have been entered into this. So looking at the block flow diagram, you can see that the feed comes in and is then splitted into overhead and bottoms product, and those have been then set up on the spreadsheet. For each stream we have mole flow rate, split ratio and mole fractions. For even number streams, the moles out is equal to moles in times split fraction, and for odd streams, moles out is equal to moles in times 1 minus of split fraction. So for stream number 2, we enter moles in, which is from stream number 1, times the split fraction, and then copy that cell to all components. For mole fraction, we can divide the moles of that component by the sum of all the components. Okay, we can lock the stream and we can copy that in all other components. Now for the stream number 3, moles in is again from stream 1 and multiplied by 1 minus of the split fraction, which is 1 minus 0.99 in this case, and that cell can then be copied over, or the formula can be copied over to all other components. So that gives us the moles of each component coming out in stream number 3. We can calculate mole fraction by just copying the formula for mole fraction in the stream number 2 and into the stream number 3. Now for stream 4, the moles in are from stream 3. So we pick up the mole flow rate from stream 3 and then multiply this with the split fraction given to us in the problem, and then copy this formula to all other components for that stream. Once again, for mole fraction, we can just copy the formula from a previous stream because mole fraction formula is the same. For stream 5, the moles in will be from stream number 3, and multiply that with 1 minus of the split fraction for the second separator, which is 1 for propane. So 1 minus 1 will give us 0, and we can copy that formula to the rest of the components. And for likewise again mole fraction, we can just copy the formula for mole fraction from a previous stream. Okay, moving on to stream 6. For stream 6, the moles in is from stream 5, so we pick up the mole for that component from stream 5, multiply it with the split fraction, and then copy that formula to all other components. For mole fraction, we just copy over the formula from a previous cell. I'm going to paste it in all other streams because the mole fraction formula is the same. Now for stream 7, again the stream coming in is into that separator is stream 5. So we multiply moles from stream 5 with 1 minus the split fraction. For stream 8, this time the moles coming in is from stream number 7, so we pick up that cell and then multiply with the split fraction given for this separator. for stream 9. Again, stream 7 is the moles coming in. Multiply that with 1 minus of the split fraction that we use for this operator. Okay, once we've copied that formula over, we get all the solutions that we are after. And you can go through the solution in your own time to see if the mass balances work out. So moving on to reactive mass balances, we have in this case total moles and total mass being conserved. Total mass being conserved for the products or the reactants coming in. The mass will be equal to the mass of the products coming out of a reactor. However, the mass or moles of each component is not conserved, and therefore we cannot use the formula that we had earlier. So in this case, we need to know what is the fractional conversion of the reactants and the stoichiometry of the equation if we are to use a mole balance. For single reactions, it's better to use mole balances when we are setting it up in Excel, whereas for multiple reactions, it's better to use extent of reaction method, which you can refer to in 2162. A single reaction mole balance can be written as a being the stoichiometric coefficient and capital A being the reactant. And so AA plus BB gives CC plus DD. So if we divide the whole thing by A, we get the stoichiometric coefficient of reactant A as 1. And the fractional conversion, if alpha is given, so moles out of reactant A will be equal to moles of A in multiplied by 1 minus of alpha, because alpha was the converted value. So 1 minus the fractional conversion will give you the moles that did not react or unreacted moles, which will be coming out. For moles of B out, it will be moles of B in minus, because it's a reactant, B over A, which is the stoichiometric ratio of the coefficients in which the reaction is taking place, multiplied by moles of A in times alpha. For the product moles out, it will be moles of C in plus C over A, which is the stoichiometric ratio of the reactant to the product. And that will be multiplied by moles of A in times alpha. And likewise for D, it's moles of D in plus D over A times moles of A in, it should be A, times alpha. Multiple reactions, mole balance is better done with extent of reaction method, and we can use the equation which we have also learned in CHE2162, where moles of each species out is equal to moles of that species in plus the stoichiometric coefficient multiplied by the extent of reaction for each reaction for that component, and then adding up all of them for the number of reactions that are given to us. To calculate the extent of reaction, if there are j number of reactions, then we need j number of specifications such as fractional conversion, yield, or selectivity. Any combination of these can be known for the number of reactions that we have been given. We look at mass balance for a process where reaction is taking place, and then there is a separator to purify the product, and then some of it is recycled back and mixed with the fresh feed stream. Here we take a very simple example where the feed stream S1 contains reactant A, which has to be converted to product B in stoichiometric proportion A to B. And in the single pass conversion, 40% of A is converted in this reactor, and the products are then separated, where S4 is pure product B and the unreacted A is recycled back to the mixer. So we take 100 mole per hour of A entering. So S1 is pure A with 100 mole per hour. Again, we can set up a Excel spreadsheet where we will be doing a number of iterations. So for each iteration, I've created a row, and for S1, we have been given 100 mole per hour of the flow rate, and we can create a column for a guess value of S5, which is the recycle stream. And for each of the other streams like S2, S3, and S4, we create a column. For S3, because some of the B is being produced in reactor, I've created two subcolumns for both the reactant and the product. So for A, the moles of A coming out of the reactor is moles coming into the reactor multiplied by 1 minus the fractional conversion. And for B, the moles out is moles in of A multiplied by the fractional conversion. And S4 is just all of the B coming into that S4 or the separator. The recycled gas this time will be equal to the actual value that we calculated in the previous iteration. And then we are going to copy and paste all the copy the cell for S2 and paste it here. So S2 is the sum of S1 plus S5. And then we can copy the formulas for the fractional conversion. And then we get a new guess value, which is 96 for the recycle stream. If we copy paste all the cells in this spreadsheet, we will slowly get all the solution that we are after. So by just double clicking at the corner of each cell, the formula gets copied over to all the cells below. And once we copy this over, you can see the solution is complete. Each time the iteration takes the guess of the actual value calculated in the previous iteration, and after about 30 iterations, we have a solution which is converged. So we should be satisfied that the number that we are after is about 150 for the recycle stream. If you want to use simultaneous equations instead of an iterative solution, we should be able to solve this in a single step. So in the first iteration, you can set this up as stream given is 100 mole per hour. We put our recycle guess value as R, which is a variable. And then S2 will be 100 plus R, which is the same formula that we entered previously. And then 0.6 is 1 minus of the fractional conversion given to us. Multiply this with the amount of A coming in, which is 100 plus R. And then B will be 0.4 times 100 plus R. And S4 is all of the B coming into it, so the same formula is copied over. And then the actual recycle rate is 0.6 times 100 plus R. And because R should be equal to 0.6 times 100 plus R, we can equate that and get the analytical solution, which gives us R equals 250. So here we are able to solve the whole thing in one iteration only, because we are solving all the equations simultaneously. However, the analytical solution is not easily done in simulations, so we are going to learn a different method to be able to do that. So here we have taken a little bit more complex problem, and we try to do this in single equation or a single step. So here ammonia is being produced in a Haber-Bosch process, in which nitrogen extracted from atmosphere is reacted with hydrogen, which is typically derived from natural gas steam reforming. And the reaction is 1 mole of nitrogen reacting with 3 moles of hydrogen to give 2 moles of ammonia. In a simplified process, a feed stream containing 100 mole per hour of nitrogen and 300 mole per hour of hydrogen is mixed with a recycle stream and sent to a reactor where equilibrium conversion of nitrogen is 25 mole per cent. The reaction products are sent to a separator where 98% of ammonia and 0.5% of each of nitrogen and hydrogen is recovered in the product stream. The remaining gases are sent to a splitter where 2% of the stream is purged and the rest is recycled, which is mixed with the fresh treat stream. So we need to develop a block flow diagram and calculate the flow rate and composition using Excel. So our diagram looks very similar to the previous problem that we did, where S1 is the feed stream, which is mixed with S5, which is the recycled stream. Here we have an added complexity of a purge stream, which is S6. The mixed stream of S1 plus S5 is S2, which goes into the reactor, and the product stream of reactor is S3, which goes into a separator, and S4 is the product stream. So we set up a similar spreadsheet, but this time we have more than one component. So we are going to set up the components on one column with different rows, and flow rates for each of those components are entered in the initial S1 stream, and the block flow diagram is copied over here. It shows the single pass conversion is 25%. So after copying the given values, we take a guess for the recycle value. Initial guess can be zero, and we look at the sum of all the moles coming into it and copy that over to all the cells going out. So this could be our trace stream, and we can check the convergence of the solution from that. So S2 is equal to S1 plus S5 for each component. So we can use that formula. For S3, we need to work out the moles out. So moles out for nitrogen is 1 minus the fractional conversion, so that's 0.75 times moles coming in. And then for hydrogen, again, it's 1 minus the fractional conversion, so 1 minus 0.25, which gives 0.75 times the moles coming in. And for ammonia, it's 0.25 times 2, which is 2 moles per mole of nitrogen. And therefore, we get moles out is 50 in the first iteration. For the product stream S4, remember we were given a value of 0.5% of hydrogen and nitrogen coming out in S4. So we multiply the moles S3 times 0.005 for both nitrogen and hydrogen. And for ammonia, it is 98%, so it's 0.98 times the moles coming into the separator. For the purge stream, the value is moles coming into the splitter, which is S3 minus S4 for each component. Multiply that with the split fraction, which in this case is 0.002, which is the purge split ratio. And then we can copy that formula over to all others, because for each component the split is the same. And this time we can then calculate the actual recycle rate for each component, which is the moles that were remaining after the separator. Multiply this with 0.98, which is 1 minus of the split purge. Okay, once we have copied the formula to other components, we can check the recycle guess value. I just fix this formula. Okay, so our initial guess was zero, but it should be equal to the actual recycle rate. If I enter that, it gives me an error. It says, careful, we have found one or more circular reference in your workbook. Ignore that and acknowledge it for now. And for all of the components, we are going to say the recycle guess equals to the actual recycle. So here to fix that, we go to File and then Options and then Formulas and click on Enable Iterative Calculation. Here the maximum iteration by default is taken as 100 and the maximum change is 0.001. We can adjust that. Right now I've chosen one iteration, and you can see after one iteration you have numbers which are not converged. So we can increase that to see how many iterations it takes for this to converge. So let's make a guess and say 20 iterations. If you take a very large number initially, it can take a long time for the Excel to solve it. So after 20, you can see the solution is still not converged. So I'm going back and change that to 100 again. And you can see after 100 iterations, it has converged the solution. So this is an equation-oriented programming where a circular reference is allowed in Excel to be able to solve in a simultaneous equation for all the values that we are after. We can use a similar approach in Aspen Plus. So here I'm showing a screen capture of the simulation. So we enter the components that we are after, so hydrogen, nitrogen, and ammonia, and we are going to simulate the same problem that we did in Excel. So my default property method for the template that I've chosen was NRTL, which is okay for this problem. I'm going to add a mixer, a stoichiometric reactor, which is R-stoic, and a flash separator and a splitter. Then add all the streams by joining these blocks. For the flash separator, we have two streams coming out, one which goes out as product, the other one goes out into the splitter, and then two streams coming out of the splitter. In the first instance, I'm not going to connect the recycle stream just yet. We want to make sure that the process simulates without a recycle stream, and then check the convergence, after which we can go for the recycle stream. So we enter the feed stream, 25 degrees Celsius and 1 bar pressure, and we enter the mole flow rates, 300 for hydrogen, 100 for nitrogen, and ammonia is 0 in the fresh feed. For the R-stoic reactor, the temperature is 25, pressure is 1 bar, and the reaction in this case is nitrogen and hydrogen reacting, so stoichiometric coefficient of nitrogen is 0.5, for hydrogen is 1.5, and for ammonia it's 1. And the fractional conversion is given as 0.25 for nitrogen, so we enter that. So R stoic is completely specified. Now we define the split ratios for S4. We knew it was 0.5% or 0.005 for hydrogen and nitrogen, and 0.98 for ammonia. And then finally for the recycle and purge splitter, S6 can be defined as 0.02 for the purge stream. And this specifies the whole system, so we should be able to run it and check the solution. If you go to the result summary and the stream table, you can see that all the values are there, and the solution converged without any problem. We go to the control panel and see it solved in the computation of B1 to B2 to B3 to B4, so it went in that sequence, and it only took one iteration. Now if we connect the recycle stream into the mixer and then realign all the streams. Okay, and rerun this simulation. We can go back and check our stream values. As you can see, the stream flow rates have changed, and we get more ammonia out in S4 than before. And you can check the numbers against the Excel spreadsheet numbers. They differ quite dramatically because obviously the thermodynamics that are built into this affects the conversion. Now, as you can see in the control panel, it started solving using S7 as the tear stream, and then solving one block at a time from B1 to B2 to B3 B4, and it took five iterations to converge the solution. and S-stream is S7 is converged, and it shows you the maximum error and tolerance. If you reset this and run again, which means we don't have the initial guess of the stream that we had initially when we solve for one pass conversion, it sees that we can see that it's solving in 6 iterations, not 5, and that the error is slightly less than before. So that shows you how Excel and Aspen Plus can be used for solving reactive balances with a recycle loop. Finally, we look at reactions where equilibrium is given instead of fractional conversion. Several reactions obviously do not go to complete conversion because they reach an equilibrium conversion. In this case, a typical example is given here. When we start off with the reactants A and B, initially the rate of reaction can be quite fast. But as we build up C and D in the reactor, the reverse reaction happens at the same time as the forward reaction, and eventually both the reactions will happen at the same rate and we will reach what is called as equilibrium conversion. The equilibrium conversion value can be calculated using equilibrium constant, which is given by a capital K and is equal to the concentration of each component to the power of their stoichiometric coefficient in the reaction, and it's the ratio of the products to the reactants. We can also calculate the equilibrium constant from Gibbs free energy, which is defined as delta G equal to minus RT and log of capital K. So if we can estimate the Gibbs free energy change, we can calculate the capital K or the equilibrium constant value. The Gibbs free energy for most components at the standard temperature of 25 degrees Celsius or 298 Kelvin is tabulated, and hence delta G can be calculated. So the delta G will be sum of all the products minus the reactants in their stoichiometric proportions. And then we can also plug in the Wontoff equation to estimate the heat of reaction using this formula here. So once we know the equilibrium constant at a given temperature, we can calculate the heat of reaction. We note that the heat of reaction itself is a function of temperature and is a non-linear function. So in the end, this is a log function, and the temperature correlation with the heat of reaction is also non-linear. So overall, the solution for equilibrium constant is a non-linear equation, for which solution in Excel can be quite complicated, although it can be done if we have an experimental data value of heat of reaction against temperature. However, it's best to solve these problems in Aspen Plus using what is called as a Gibbs reactor. The way Gibbs reactor works is it tries to minimize the Gibbs free energy change for any given reaction. So we don't need to specify the stoichiometric equation for a Gibbs reactor. It will calculate all the possible products that we ask it to calculate for, and it will give you a composition of the product stream from a reactor just on the basis of the thermodynamics of the reaction. So we solved the same problem as before for ammonia synthesis from hydrogen and nitrogen. However, this time we are going to run it in the industrial temperature of 350 degrees Celsius and around 200 bar. And our job is to calculate single pass conversion and compare it against the conversion that was given to us earlier, which was 25 mole per cent. So to do that, we start off with a new file in Aspen Plus. We check it's the metric system. Once the file is open, we enter the components that we are after: nitrogen, hydrogen, and ammonia. Again, in the template, I have used NRTL as the fluid package, which is fine for this method. Once again, we're going to add the same blocks, but this time, instead of using R-stoic, we're going to use R-Gibbs. And we're going to use a separator to separate the products. And we use a splitter to introduce the recycle stream and the purge stream. Once we have all the blocks, we can connect those streams. Okay, once we have all the streams connected, we're going to align them properly and then again solve this problem without connecting the recycle loop first to see if the blocks have been set up correctly. Okay, let's enter S1. This time we're going to use 350 degrees Celsius as the temperature. And the pressure was 200 bar. And mole flow rates are the same as before, 100 mole per hour for nitrogen, 300 for hydrogen, and ammonia is zero. Gibbs reactor, we need to only specify temperature and pressure this time. Pressure is 200 bar and temperature is 350 degrees Celsius. Note that we don't need to specify the reaction or the fractional conversion here. For the separator, again, we enter the split fractions that were given to us in the previous sheet. So for S4, we can enter the values of 0.005 for nitrogen and hydrogen and 0.98 for ammonia. Finally, for the splitter, the split fraction for S6, which is the purge stream, is 0.02. That completes the input, and we run the simulation to see if it converges. It does, without any error. We can go and check the solution in the stream table, in the results summary. So from here you can work out the fractional conversion without the recycle stream. Okay, so hydrogen and so nitrogen is 100 entering and 34 leaving, so 66 moles is converted. Now once we've connected the recycle stream, we run this again and check our stream table. This time, as you can see, the moles of nitrogen entering is 151 and moles coming out is 53.264. So if we want to calculate the single pass conversion, we can enter those values and we can see we get 65% conversion nearly. So that concludes this part of the simulations, and then we can go to equation-oriented programming in the following lecture. Thanks for listening to me, and I look forward to meeting you during the tutorials.